We've all seen these guys before. Alkaline dry cells power a lot of our daily lives. From remote controls to kids' toys. This battery became commercially available in the 50s and is today the most common household battery.
So what exactly are alkaline dry cells? Well, it's a type of primary battery where the electrolyte has a pH value above 7, typically deriving energy from the reaction of zinc metal and manganese dioxide. Electrochemically speaking, the steel can of the alkaline battery serves as the current collector for the cathode, which is a dense mass of manganese dioxide and carbon packed within the can. This cathodic mass has a hollow center that is lined to separate it from the anode, which is another mixture consisting of zinc powder and the alkaline electrolyte. Contact between the anode and cathode is achieved by a metal pin or leaf inserted into the anode mix. The alkaline battery derives its power from the reduction of the manganese dioxide cathode and the oxidation of the zinc anode. Unfortunately, these batteries are wasteful. Dry cells are designed to be discharged only once and then discarded. In the US alone, Americans throw away more than 3 billion batteries, and the average American household buys as many as 90 alkaline batteries annually. And 86,000 tons of hazardous waste comes from single-use alkaline batteries. Disposable alkalines are not only causing huge amounts of hazardous waste, but their manufacturing is destroying our planet. Metals accounted for nearly two-thirds of the 3.3 billion pounds of TRI chemicals released in 2022. Metals are primarily disposed up to land, while most nitrate compounds are discharged to water and ammonia is primarily released to air. Many have proposed a switch to the far more powerful, rechargeable, and longer-lasting lithium-ion batteries, but not so fast. Alkaline batteries actually have a lower carbon footprint, as they use more readily available materials and require less energy for production. Lithium batteries are difficult to recycle and often end up in landfills, leading to potential soil and water. So what should we do? People still need to use batteries to power their lives, and until an awesome, renewable, and environmental solution comes along, we'll have to stick to alkalines. It's not all bad. There are ways to seriously curb the harmful effects of disposables. Instead of transitioning to labor-intensive lithium-ion batteries, we should instead focus on recycling the metals and materials already being used in disposable alkalines, thereby reducing our need to continue mining. For a sustainable future, we must properly handle and recycle our used alkaline batteries, which means the government must take responsibility and instill a nationwide battery recycling program, which programs like these already exist in California, for example. People must also limit their consumption of disposables and instead focus on purchasing rechargeable batteries. Rechargeables are less wasteful and more economical. They pay for themselves after only 6 charges. We don't currently have a ton of options, but a focus on recycling and recharging will taper the damage to our planet until we discover a new technology. So are you broken on me is someday.